إن الحمد لله نحمده ونستعينه ونستغفره ونعوذ بالله من شرور أنفسنا ومن سيئات أعمالنا، من يهده الله فلا مضل له ومن يضلل فلا هادي له، وأشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له، وأشهد أن محمدا عبده ورسوله. يا أيها الذين آمنوا اتقوا الله حق تقاته ولا تموتن إلا وأنتم مسلمون. يا أيها الناس اتقوا ربكم الذي خلقكم من نفس واحدة وخلق منها زوجها بث منهما رجالا كثيرا ونساء، واتقوا الله الذي تساءلون به والأرحام، إن الله كان عليكم رقيبا. يا أيها الذين آمنوا اتقوا الله وقولوا قولا سديدا يصلح لكم أعمالكم ويغفر لكم ذنوبكم، ومن يطع الله ورسوله فقد فاز فوزا عظيما. أما بعد، فإن أصدق الحديث كتاب الله، وخير الهدي هدي محمد صلى الله عليه وسلم، شر الأمور محدثاتها، وكل محدثة بدعة، كل بدعة ضلالة، وكل ضلالة في النار. The heart of the Muslim should be very strong. One of the things the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم mentioned for us to have a strong heart. And if you have a strong heart, then you will be a strong believer. Which is حسن الظن بالله. Good expectation, good think about your Lord, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. He said, صلى الله عليه وسلم, يقول الله تعالى, أنا إن ظن عبدي بي وأنا معه إذا ذكرني, فإن ذكرني في نفسه ذكرته في نفسي, وإن ذكرني في ملأ ذكرته في ملأ خير منه. He said, sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, I am as my slave expects me to be, and I am with him when he remembers me. What do you think about your Lord? You think that he will help you? He will forgive your sins? He will support the need? Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will be according to your thinking. Think good about your Lord. سبحانه وتعالى. We have the examples from the Quran and the Sunnah. One great example of that concept, of that belief, موسى عليه الصلاة والسلام. The ayat Allah سبحانه وتعالى said when he took Bani Israel, they escaped from Fir'aun. Then Allah سبحانه وتعالى said, فلما تراء الجمعان قال أصحاب موسى إنا لمدركون. مباشرة قال كلا إن معي ربي سيهدين. حسن الظن بالله وقوة اليقين. And when the two groups, the group of Musa عليه الصلاة والسلام and the group of Fir'aun, and when the two groups saw one another, which means they are very close, the group of Musa صلى الله عليه وسلم said, indeed we are to be overtaken. So what was the reply of Musa alayhi salatu wasalam, the strong believer, حُسْنُ الظَّنِّ بِاللَّهِ here? He said immediately, قَالَ كَلَّا, no. Indeed with me is my Lord. He will guide me. What kind of army that he had that time, Musa alayhi salatu wasalam? No army at all. He has the Bani Israel, the kids, the women, the weak people. They don't have weapons. They are not prepared. But he had that time the strong faith. حسن الظن بالله, thinking good about his Lord. Because Allah promised Allah will protect him. And Allah will protect the believers. Allah with the believers. Allah with those who are patient. So he had that faith. حسن الظن بالله. And immediately Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said to Musa, فَأَوْحَيْنَا إِلَى مُوسَى أَنِ اضْرِبْ بِعَصَاكَ الْبَحْرِ فَانْفَلَقَ فَكَانَ كُلُّ فِرْقٍ كَالطَّوْدِ الْعَظِيمِ. Then we inspired Musa, strike with your staff the sea, and it parted. And each portion was like a great towering mountain. حسن الظن بالله, think good about your Lord, and he will be that, like that. The mother of Ismail, عليه الصلاة والسلام, هاجر. You know the story when Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala told Ibrahim take عليه الصلاة والسلام take your wife Hajar and your son baby. He was maybe a few days or few weeks his age. Take them to Mecca. That time, no Zamzam water, no Kaaba. And you know Mecca, that desert, nothing. So he left Hajar with his son Ismail. And he did not mention any word for them. Then she called Ibrahim, Hajar, called Umm Ismail. She called Ibrahim, alayhi salatu wasalam. Ya Ibrahim, she was calling him. Ya Ibrahim, Ya Ibrahim, O Ibrahim, ila man takiluna. You left us here. Who should take us? Who should take the responsibility of us? Ibrahim alayhi salatu wasalam did not answer. He did not answer. Then she asked him, Umm Ismail asked Ibrahim alayhi salatu wasalam. Then she asked him by saying, Allahu amaraka bidhalik. Had Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala ordered you to leave us here? Ibrahim said, yes. Then she said, إذن لن يضيعنا. Allah will not neglect us. Subhanallah. What kind of faith that she had? And after some time, very short time, Zamzam came from beneath her son Ismail عليه الصلاة والسلام. And the tribe Jurhum came there and they lived with Ismail and Ismail. Our Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. في قصة الهجرة. The story of الهجرة, the migration from Mecca to Medina. He left sallallahu alayhi wa sallam Mecca only with Abu Bakr. Two people. No army. No soldiers with him. No one to guard him sallallahu alayhi wa sallam except Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. They went inside the Ghar Thawr, the cave of Thawr. Abu Bakr said, to follow the logic, and this is important, to follow the logic, not to ignore the material things. We have to take our means to achieve what Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala told us. Abu Bakr said, Ya Rasul Allah, if any of them should look under his feet, he would see us. لو نظر أحدهم أسفل قدمي لرآنا. He said صلى الله عليه وسلم, O Abu Bakr, ما ظنك باثنين الله ثالثهما. O Abu Bakr, what do you think about two persons? Allah is the third. So they left. They could not see the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم with Abu Bakr. This is the yaqeen. حسن الظن بالله, to think good about your Lord Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. How can I know if I have this concept, I have this faith? When you notice yourself working toward the Akhirah, because حسن الظن بالله, thinking good about your Lord subhanahu wa ta'ala, pushes you toward the good deeds. Al-Hasan al-Basri رحمه الله said, إن المؤمن أحسن الظن بربي فأحسن العمل. The believer, what is the meaning? The believer means the real Muslim. Not just to claim I am Muslim. Believer, the real Muslim. أحسن الظن بربه. He is thinking good about his Lord. فأحسن العمل. Then he's doing the righteous deed. He's doing the righteous deed. While al-munafiq, the opposite side, al-munafiq, asa'a al-dhanna bi rabbi fa asa'a al-amal. The hypocrite, because he thinks and he believes bad, expecting bad from his Lord, that's why he's doing bad. A very nice statement from al-Hasan al-Basri rahimahullah. Ibn al-Qayyim rahimahullah said, the slave pushes, what pushes him to do the good deeds, حسن الظن بالله. Thinking good about your Lord. Think good about your Lord. No, but I have a lot of sins. I did this major mistake. I'm not praying for 10 years, 20 years. I'm not fasting. I'm stealing. I'm taking riba. So for sure Allah will not forgive my sins. No, this is the way of the kuffar. But the believer thinks good about his Lord and he makes good deeds to get the forgiveness of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. قُلْ مَا تَسْمَعُونَ وَاسْتَغْفِرُوا اللَّهِ وَلَكُمْ. الحمد لله وحده والصلاة والسلام على من لا نبي بعد. أما بعد, as we mentioned, the believer thinks good about his Lord. And the opposite, the hypocrite, thinks bad about his Lord. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says in Surah Fath, وَيُعَذِّبَ الْمُنَافِقِينَ وَالْمُنَافِقَاتِ وَالْمُشْرِكِينَ وَالْمُشْرِكَاتِ الظَّانِّينَ بِاللَّهِ ظَنَّ السَّوْءِ عَلَيْهِمْ دَائِرَةُ السَّوْءِ. Also so that he may punish hypocrite men and women and polytheistic men and women who harbor evil thoughts of Allah. Also another ayah, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said in Surah Ali Imran, وَطَائِفَةٌ قَدْ أَهَمَّتْهُمْ أَنفُسُهُمْ يَظُنُّونَ بِاللَّهِ غَيْرَ الْحَقِّ ظَنَّ الْجَاهِلِيَّةِ. Subhanallah. Also they think bad about their Lord, and this is the thinking and the believing or the belief of the kuffar and jahiliyyah. So the Muslim, the believer, should be with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and Allah will be with him. In a very nice hadith, the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, which is, this is hadith Qudsi, a slave committed a sin. And all of us, this is a slave. Don't think when we mention like this hadith, we are talking about someone in a different planet. We are talking about ourselves. This hadith talks about us, or many of us. A slave committed a sin. And he said, oh Allah, forgive my sin. And Allah said, my slave committed a sin. And then he realized, this is the good thing about your Lord. Then he realized that he has a Rabb. He has the Lord subhanahu wa ta'ala who forgives the sins and punishes for the sin. He then again committed a sin and said, my Rabb, forgive my son, my sin. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, my slave committed a sin. And then realized that he has a Rabb who forgives his sin and punishes for the sin. He again committed a sin and said, my Rabb, forgive my sin. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, my slave has committed a sin. And then realized that he has a Rabb who forgives the sin or takes him to account for sin. Then at the end of the hadith, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, I have granted forgiveness to my slave. Let him do whatever he likes. Of course, it doesn't mean let him do whatever he likes. Do the sins as much as you can. It doesn't mean that. It means as long as he keeps asking for forgiveness after the commission of sins and repents, Allah will forgive him, because repentance eliminates previous sins. Again, it doesn't mean do whatever you like, do the sins, disobey Allah, never. But it means that slave, this kind of Muslim, he knows and he believes that Allah forgives, so he is repenting again and again. So this is the issue. Kullu bani Adam, the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam said, kullu bani Adam khata. All of us, all the children of Adam, khata, doing sins, committing sins regularly. But he said, sallallahu alaihi wasallam, next to that, وَخَيْرُ الْخَطَّائِينَ التَّوَابُونَ. The best among those who are sinners, those who repent. So this is the meaning of the hadith. In the dua, the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam said, ادعوا الله وأنتم موقنون بالإجابة واعلموا أن الله لا يستجيب دعاء من قلب غافل له. supplicate Allah when you are assured of being answered. This is the حسن الظن بالله. And هذا الحديث, the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم said, لا يموتن أحد أحدكم إلا وهو يحسن الظن بربه. Let none of you die unless he has good expectations from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And I end with this nice, very nice hadith. The Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم visited a young man. Then he asked him, كيف تجدك? How do you feel? He said, this man, I have hope in Allah. I have hope in Allah. This is حسن الظن بالله, thinking good about your Lord, believing good about your Lord. I have hope in Allah, O Rasulullah, but I fear my sins. This is the real believer. Two sides, the side of hope and the side of fear. We need both of them. O Rasulullah, I have the hope and I have also the fear. Then the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم said, لا يجتمعان في قلب عبد في مثل هذا الموطن إلا أعطاه الله ما يرجو وأمنه مما يخاف. These two things, the fear and hope, don't coexist in the heart of a person in a situation like this, but Allah will give him that which he hopes for and keep him safe from that which he fears. اللهم اغفر للمؤمنين والمؤمنات والمسلمين والمسلمات الأحياء منهم والأموات إنك سميع قريب مجيب الدعوات يا رب العالمين. اللهم اجعل هذا بلد آمنا مطمئنا وسائر بلاد المسلمين. ربنا آتنا في الدنيا حسنة وفي الآخرة حسنة وقنا عذاب النار. اللهم حبب إلينا الإيمان وزينه في قلوبنا وكره إلينا الكفر والفسوق والعصيان. اجعلنا اللهم من الراشدين. اللهم ارحم موتانا وعاف مبتلانا واشف مرضانا. حفظ الشباب والبنات المخدرات والمعاكسات يا رب العالمين. اللهم وفق ولاة أمورنا لما تحب وترضى. اللهم وحد الأمة الإسلامية على الخير والبر والتقوى والتوحيد والسنة. اللهم نجي إخوان المسلمين في كل مكان يا رب العالمين. اللهم حرر المسجد الأقصى من أيدي الغاصبين. اللهم احفظ إخوان المسلمين في فلسطين في غزة. اللهم استر عوراتهم وآمن روعاتهم. اللهم احفظهم بين أيديهم ومن خلفهم ومن خلفهم وعن أيمانهم وعن شمائلهم. ونعوذ بعظمتك أن يغتالوا من تحتهم. وآخر دعوانا الحمد لله رب العالمين.